Okay, so 13th of August, 13th of the 8th, 2018. I've been running fuel pressure tests and I haven't been finding any problems with the tests I've been running. However, I have found a clogged vent. So I think before I might have pointed out that the vent runs from the tank. It comes out here and it runs up to here. Excuse my camera freezing. I don't know what that is, but anyway, we've got this vent coming out here, and that goes all the way back to the tanks at the back of the truck. So, and that's blocked. So I'll try and blow through that now. There's absolutely no airflow from here to the tank. So what that does is it goes down there and across underneath the engine. So we're under the car now, the engine's up there, there's the flywheel, and the vent goes from rubber, turns into a steel line, runs along here, and it comes out here. So that's the rubber line there. That connects, just get the light, that connects there. I've got this piece of test rubber hose going down and coming out there. So that's connecting to where this hose here connected to. So this is the hose running up to the tanks, and I'll try and get it on film that I'm blowing. And you may be able to hear that in the tanks. And yet, if I blow on the vent going back to the engine bay, there's nothing. I can't get any air past there, so that could be a problem. Okay, so I'll try and find the blockage in this pipe, and as I say, it's coming out in the engine bay there. I'll look into that, and I'll see what I can find. If I can't find the blockage, I'll just replace it with one piece of rubber going from all the way here down to the back. Could be about, say, 4 or 5 meters. So my guess is that what's happened is dirt and grit has fallen down the inlet there over time, and probably this piece of rubber is blocked, but I'll look into that and I'll let you know what I find. Okay, well this is clear. Just demonstrate. So that's not clogged up. So it's the metal line. But let's do the test now. I'll start it up, and we'll see if the fuel pressure drops. Okay, I'll get the timer out, and we'll watch the fuel pressure gauge. So that's a little bit not so clear, but we've got, I think, 0, 3, 6, 9, 12. Okay, well, surprisingly, that hasn't fixed the problem. It's strange because there was no ventilation at all in the vent pipe. There is a problem with the vent system within the fuel system of this truck. That's probably where the actual problem lies, I'd say. Okay, so prior to this, before this video, the fuel filter has been replaced. The fuel pump and the fuel pump pushrod have all been replaced. Okay, so the next test, I'll have to wait for it to cool off because the exhaust pipe is hot and the fuel pressure has to reset back to... The funny thing is that when I start up the truck, it does go straight to 9 PSI where it should be. But then it decreases. But anyway, what I'm going to do for the next test is drop the line from the tank and just have the line sitting in a bucket of fuel, and we'll just see how she goes then. But yeah, I think the problem is in the ventilation system, where a vacuum is being created and not allowing the fuel flow. But really, for that, at this point, I'd say that the tanks have to be dropped and inspected. Okay, the second test of the day is we've got the line, the fuel line coming into the pump. That's it there. You can see there's a fuel filter. So we're going from the pump, we're going back to a bucket with the line dropped into it. Okay, so that's the fuel line. You might be able to see there. It goes, where are we now? It goes up and over there, down, and into the bucket. So this probably cuts out all ventilation issues and fuel tank issues. So this should be an interesting one. Okay, we've got 18 past 12, so that's where the big hand is. So we'd have to get 15 minutes of good operating fuel system. So I'll start the engine. That is to say, I'll check that it's okay to start the engine, and then I'll start the engine. As you can see, the fuel pressure's down on startup. So after this morning's start, if you started after a long time standing, the fuel pressure's okay, but it doesn't seem to come up, and it's not increasing with the test. So maybe there's something I'm not understanding about the fuel system. Okay, this is a simple fuel line test. It's a test without the fuel filter. Okay, you can see that that hose there. So that's connecting to the fuel pump, coming around, going back, and it's connecting to the line. From the tank, so the line from the tank is the metal bit coming around there, and it goes around and back to the fuel pump. Okay, so I'm thinking, let's go one better. Let's connect the tank straight up to the line. So that is to say, let's connect the petrol tank straight up to the fuel pump. Okay, so that line there goes up to the engine, and the inlet for the fuel pump is coming down and going straight into the fuel tank. When you're doing these tests, always get the light away from the fuel, and just make sure there's not going to be any problems. Okay, I'll walk this electrical lead well away from the tank and everything. Okay, so with this test we're losing fuel pressure just like all the other tests, and there's no real difference. I might look into if there's a fuel pressure regulator on the Holley carburetor. I'm just starting to think that the type of fuel pump sold for this vehicle could be wrong. I'm starting to think it's a fuel pump. I don't think it's the fuel gauge, because it reacted to my pressurizing or pinching of the fuel line. We know that everything back from the fuel pump is fine, because any of these tests haven't made a difference. So it's actually all coming back to the fuel pump, or the cam inside the engine driving the fuel pump push rod.
The reason I don't think it's the cam inside the engine is because if you leave it overnight, when you first start it up, you get the 6 psi pressure, which is the perfect pressure for this carburetor, for this engine. So all I can think of is the diaphragm inside the fuel pump. If when it rests overnight, and it's not heated up, when it becomes cold, it becomes, it sort of becomes reset back to the original rubber tension, and that's how you get it operating and performing well when you first start it up the next day. There is one last thing that I'm thinking about that the problem could be. So it's got a blocked vent line. What could be happening is a new fuel pump is being put on, and then because the fuel pump can't use the vent line, it's making some sort of suction drawback and destroying the diaphragm in the fuel pump. Or another thing could be, if it's a fuel pump, is you know, there's a different sort of fuel being used these days, and that could be the reason, and the rubber's getting destroyed in the diaphragm's being destroyed in the fuel pump. So from today's tests, it's coming back to either a worn cam driving the fuel pump or the fuel pump.